Today, I want to talk about a problem that I see happen over and over again when people feel lost and they go searching for an answer. Listening to too many mentors.
In that time, I was having like an internship with a super photographer in Italy. And I had like this mixed feeling because I had all these inputs. Both of you were saying the same things, but in a different way.
Having too many people pointing the way out for you is like the ideal way of procrastinating, isn't it? When you outsource your thinking, then you don't have to take action. That way you could keep deluding yourself that there's this ultimate truth that you're looking for. And maybe it's that next super wise person that's going to give it to you. Well, the truth doesn't work that way. You will never believe anything that you don't physically experience yourself. After you get your information from a credible source, act on it, like right away. See, you could hear the same thing from 8 different people in 8 different ways, in 8 different languages, and it will never truly sink in. Not until you go out and experience it for yourself, like in your bones. Make it your flesh. Right now, if you're struggling with moving forward, it may be that there are too many cooks in the kitchen of your mind.
I found myself in a position where I've got a few different mentors in different areas that have kind of like laid it out for me a lot more plain that I need to, you know, this is what I need to do if I want to take it seriously. I guess I'm at a crossroads. Is kind of an overused term, but I came to a bunch of realizations over the past month that I hadn't been taking it seriously enough. And, you know, coming to understand why I guess I'm in that position.
Try to narrow the amount of voices that you listen to.
Right.
Try to have less mentors. The thing with different people saying different things is that they could all be saying great things, but because we have to rely on words to express ourselves, there's a lot of contradictory ways of getting the same spirit across.
Right.
And what's most important for you is that you get the spirit across so that you know how to act going forward. But if you have different mentors, then you're going to get in a situation where you're like, well, that person said this, but then there's this other approach. And you're already doing that in your mind. So
Right. What
you need is someone that will put that shit into focus so that you don't have to keep going back and forth, but you could go in a straight line so you could start seeing some results. Because you can't have an iterative process without that straight line. If you keep jumping from thing to thing or idea to idea or concept or doing it a different way because of some other external voice, then you're not building on those primary blocks so that you could see if what you're doing is bringing you the results that you want. Because no matter which direction you go in, you can win. What will kill you is if you go in a million different directions. You have to go super narrow and go super deep. But here you are, unable to act.
Right.
Despite the fact that you have a million mentors. Mm. Why?
Why?
Because you have a million mentors.
You tricked me.
Having so many inputs buys you time so you can think about it, right?
Right.
Then after you think about it, you get a second opinion, right?
Right.
That's why you read all those books and you listen to all those podcasts. And when someone along the way gives you a contradictory opinion, everything stops.
Oh my God, you're so right.
Then you're confused.
Yep.
Someone has to be lying. So now you have this internal debate, which person is right, which concept is true.
Oh shit, exactly.
It's literally Overthinkers Anonymous. Mm. When all you have to do is go out there and find out for yourself.
Really?
You don't need to take anyone's word for it.
Really?
The people who are further along the journey, all they can do for you is point to the holes in the ground that they came across. But who knows? Maybe those holes already got filled in.
Right.
Or maybe there's other holes that those people didn't see.
Right, right.
You got to go out there and discover it for yourself. Don't get me wrong. Those further along, they can help.
Okay.
By making you pay attention to things that you may have otherwise missed.
Okay.
But what they can't do is do the push-ups for you.
Mm.
Look, I see it over and over again.
Oh my God,
and it's weird to call it this, but...
What?
This is information junkie syndrome.
What's that?
You know, the people who say, let me read about how I should go out and say hello to strangers more. Or let me read about how I should promote myself more. Mm. Let me read about getting better at making art. Let me go watch another YouTube video about time management for creatives.
Oh my God, that's me.
And then they wonder why they're standing still. You can't get your information from a million different sources and then expect it all to be cohesive.
Mm-hmm.
That's not how it works.
Fuck.
Look, successful people do have mentors, but one at a time.
Right.
You need to invest in one system. Right now, there are too many cooks in the kitchen of your mind.
Yeah, I think so. I have a guy that I'm sort of a month-long course, and I'm studying some other, like I'm studying Qigong right now. And then, you know, I've been looking at your course, Mystery School. And for me, it all kind of like, it all points in the same direction, but I get what you're saying about voices. And for me, that's always been a lot of my problem, using other people's directions, I guess, in lieu of my own, like not having really my own process of making decisions about, you know, what I want to do. It's always been like sort of external. So I've been kind of like taking what's useful, getting rid of what's useless and adding what's mine, that sort of thing. But depth and focus is what I need right now. Some of the information seems incomplete as far as what I'm looking for. Realizing that's maybe part of my problem too, is trying to kind of like figure out the whole puzzle all at once.
Stop using information as a drug that pacifies you from actually going out there and taking action. Words are only the half of it. They're only there to tire you out until all you have left to do is act. That's why someone that's doing it or being it already is the perfect mentor. Because when they shut up, they're still speaking the truth. Pick that person to be your Mr. Miyagi for the next little while and do whatever they say. Once you've found that person, seriously, ignore everything else. That is the only sort of dedication that gets results. Because right now, there are too many cooks in the kitchen of your mind.